Well, after a vote recount, officials say the Dresden School District's budget has failed after all. Originally, the budget for the district, which includes Hanover, New Hampshire, and Norwich, Vermont, came down to a tie. But after a recount of the votes, turns out it was not a tie. The $22.7 million budget proposal failed by just two votes. Meanwhile, a school bond to revitalize Stevens High School in Claremont passed on their town meeting day by just two votes, but a recount a week later showed it failed by just one vote. News Channel 5's Jackie Bender met with the superintendent to find out what happens now.
They won by the first vote. Why should they have to have a recount and so they can lose it? They should have left it just the way it was.
Administrators in Claremont said they knew they needed a recount when their $22.9 million bond narrowly passed. Now that the bond failed in a recount, there are more questions.
If they miscounted the first time, how do we know they didn't miscount the second time?
The school board would have to appeal to the Supreme Court to have a second recount, and that recount would only be approved under certain conditions.
And it has to be around process, that there was a procedural error. Those are the kinds of things that Superior Court is generally open to considering.
Superintendent Jackie Gillette says that nearly 2,300 votes were counted and recounted, with observers present. The school board is still weighing its final decision, but she doubts they have a case.
This was as clean a count as I could possibly imagine. So I don't see any grounds for a recount.
If the school board agrees, they have at least two more options, revoting on the same budget or modifying it.
And the plan that we had that was just voted on, that's a good plan. That's very, very solid. But there may be changes that can be done and different ways of looking at things.
And now the race is on to find a plan that voters will pass before state aid goes away at the end of June. In Claremont, New Hampshire, Jackie Bender, News Channel 5.